गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन आवर फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर क्लास। चैप्टर 1, इंट्रोडक्शन टू कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट कंप्यूटर नेटवर्किंग। कंप्यूटर नेटवर्किंग मीन्स मोर देन टू कंप्यूटर कनेक्टेड विद इंटरनेट, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू कैन शेयर योर फाइल्स, वीडियोज एक्सेट्रा, and you can share your device, means you can see other computer through your computer and you can work on it also. Now we will go on next topic, standalone computer. Standalone computer means what? Standalone computer means in our house two or more computer are there, but they are not connected with each other, that known as a standalone computer. See on picture, computer in study room and computer in drawing room. These both computer are in one house, but they are not attached with each other. That's why it's known as a standalone computer. Now we will see a disadvantages of standalone computer. Number 1, standalone computer cannot exchange your data. Means students, if you want to share your file from your computer to another, you cannot send it. But if you want to share, then you have to use a removable device like pen drive, DVD, removable hard disk, etc. Number 2 point, this removable device take a time to transfer your data. Number 3, if one computer attached with the printer, then you cannot take a printout from other computer. Now we'll see a simplest computer network. Simplest computer network is connected by two computers and wireless printer. With the help of this network, you can take a printout from any of that computer. See here, two computers are there, and you can take a printout from any one computer because this printer is attached with the network. Next point, large computer network means you can connect more than two computer and share your file also. Now we will see a types of computer network. Computer networks are broadly classified into the following three categories. Number 1, local area network, LAN, metropolitan area network, MAN, wild area network, WAN, LAN, MAN, WAN. These are the shortcut of the network is. Now we will learn about local area network. Local area network, in this network, computers are located with a short distance, means each computer distance is maximum of 1 or 2 kilometers from each other. See on picture, principal office, account department, games department, computer lab, these all are in the one building, means it all are in the short distance. That's why here you can use a local area network. Now we will see a characteristics of local area network. Local area network are mostly used in house, building or campus by using personal line of wire. And this LAN network transfer a data at very high speed. Means you can transfer your data very speedily. Now we will see example of local area network. At home, when multiple computers are connected to each other, that is known as a local area network. See here, in one house, computers are connected with each other, means one computer in drawing room, computer in bedroom, computers in study room, these all are connected in a short distance, and it means it is using a local area network. Same way, in the school and colleges, you can see a computers of computer room are connected together. Now we will see a next network, means metropolitan area network. This metropolitan area network, also known as a MAN, and this network connected a large area such as a city means from several building to entire city. Now we will see a characteristics of metropolitan area. A metropolitan area network can cover an area of 5 km to 50 km. This network can use a single person or organization company, and this network provide high speed connectivity. Now we will see an example of metropolitan area network. Any of company has office located at a different streets of city, then they are use this network. For example, in Mumbai, banks are there like Bank of India and its sub branch in Dadar, Bandra, Andheri, Borivali, etc. Means in one city, this bank has a sub branch in different street. Same way, organization like Bank of India organization has multiple city also, like it connected like a Mumbai, Delhi, Lucknow. Means one branch can work on the street also, and this then network can work on the multiple city also. Now we will learn about wild area network. Wild area network extend over a large geographical area such as a country or continent. Now we will learn about characteristics of wild area network. In wild area, computers are connected together by using a public line of wires. Means people can connected of telephone system throughout satellite. And this wild area speed is slower than local area network. Now we will see an example of wild area network. You can send your mails or you can chat with the different countries of people, and different countries are connected together. Means you can work with from one country to another country. It means this country are also connected and people also connected with the each other country or other company also. That's why it using a wild area network. Now we will learn about advantages of networking. Number one, you can send your data or messages accurately in very short time. You can send your messages in a short time. Number two, reduce computer hardware required in a network, means in computer lab. From any computer you can give a command for print of single printer. Means in computer lab you can give a print command for printout from any computer. Now point number three, with the help of fast communication, people can chat or send the mails to each other. Means with the help of this communication, people can send mails or messages very speedily. These are the advantages of networking. Now we'll see a disadvantages of networking. Disadvantages of networking. Server is not working, then all other computers network become down and people may not be able to work. Means server means main computer having a internet, and through that computer get internet all of other computer. If server is not work, then how can work or other computer, and people also cannot work. Number two, unauthorized person means those who don't have a permission. That person can hack your sites and they can see your secret information and pass it to other. Number three, setting of computer network is costly and required additional money. Means if you want to internet at your home, that is very costly and you have to spend extra money also. All of you understood? These are the disadvantages of networking. Here children, chapter number one finished. Introduction of internet. Now You have to fill a Google form with the help of this video and my explanation. Thank you.